Good morning, everyone. So today we'll be discussing our second program in macro, that is login. So the concept is that you will have a general login page from where you will put some ID and password in these two columns, that is B2 and B3. In these two cells, you will put some value and click on login. So if it matches the data, then it will go to its corresponding sheet. That is, if it's BA, then it will go to BA. If it's finance, then it go to finance page. If it's HR, then it go to HR page. If it is on SCLM, then it will go to SCLM. If it's marketing, it will go to marketing. Else, if there is any password error, that is, if the password doesn't match to any one of them, so they will say invalid password and please contact your network administrator. And the last part, that is, if you keep it blank and click on login, it will say that it's not like it's invalid. So please, not invalid, it is empty. So please fill some data. Okay. So for that, what we did is, as you can see, the subject and access code written on A2 and A3. And apart from that, in the login, this is a button. So if anyone is having any confusion related to ActiveX, button insertion, what you need to do, you need to go to developer, and then from here you need to click on insert, and you will find this button. This is the button that we are going to use. So you click on this and you draw it over here. Okay, so now we'll start with our coding. That is, we'll look into the code for the login. Okay. So as you can see that we are using the value, we are matching the value. So this is the, there is a decision-making statement, that is if, else if. So we are using nested else if out here. That is, first it will check if range b2 dot value is equal to business analytics and range b3 dot value is equal to ba@123. So this is the decision making statement that it will match. So if its value is b2, its value is business analytics, and range b3 dot value is equal to ba@123, then it will select sheet ba, that is the sheet which name is BA. So if you just go and check on that Excel sheet, the name of that sheet is BA. So this needs to match, the entire alphabet needs to, I mean, then this is case sensitive. So the entire spelling in along with its uppercase and lowercase, it should be exactly the same, else it will not work. So now talking about and, the condition of and is it needs to match both of them. So if range b2 dot value is equal to business analytics and range b3 dot value is something else, it will not run. But for it needs to be, both of them needs to be satisfied, then only it will select this. So I think that we discussed in our if condition statement, I mean the logical statement explanation, that is and, or, and all. So now else if. So the point of else if is that if this doesn't happen, then only it will move to else if. So else if, the same condition, that is for finance, that is if b2 dot value is equal to finance and range b3 dot value is equal to fin and then it 123, then it will select sheet finance dot select. And okay, so now this is a nested condition, that is if, else if, else if. So first if, then it will move to else. First this else if. If this also doesn't satisfy, then it will go to the next else if. So it's like indentation. It goes on from the first one in a hierarchical way. So now it will check whether it's B2 is equal to HR and HR at the rate 123. It will open HR. Else if. So again, it will go move into the next hierarchy. It will check. If it's SCLM, then it will open. Okay. This will be sclm.select. And if it's marketing, then it will again go in, and the name of the, this one is marketing. So we need to exactly copy the spelling. So it will go to marketing.select. Okay, so now else if range b2.value is equal to blank and range b3.value is equal to blank, then msg box, that is message box, fill, please fill your necessary details. So this message box is a function of VBA macro, that is it shows a pop-up message. So if it's blank, then the pop-up message will come and it will show, please fill your necessary details. Now else, so this, if all these doesn't happen, then there's an else. So else doesn't have any condition. So it's like if this doesn't support, then directly this will happen. So else doesn't have a statement, doesn't have a condition. If all the ifs fail, then else is the final statement, which will have wrong input, or please contact your network admin. So I have put all, we have put all the data out here for business analytics, for finance, for HR, for SCLM, for marketing, and for blank. So if none of these conditions satisfy, then for all the other conditions, if you put anything, you put your friend's name, anything else, then it directly will show me wrong input. Please contact your network admin. And there's an end if. So this entire thing will be inside this if and end if. And private sub, end sub. So this is how the scope works. So this is the code. And now we will just have the demonstration. So save it first. Now I'll put up the design mode. Now I click on login. As you can see, please fill necessary details. I put my name out here, and wrong input, please contact network admin. BA BA @123. Okay, so I think I have made a mistake with the code. The value was business analytics. So what I need to do, and this one will be okay. So my BA page got opened. Now I'll again go to for the H finance. So it opened the finance page. I'll go to HR. Okay. SLM. I'll open marketing. Okay, so this is the code. I have uploaded that assignment and the assignment of the Google Classroom account, and you all are requested to get into that and try to recreate this entire Excel. You will have that Excel. All you need to do is go to the design mode, click on this login button. We'll get this section. You'll get this section and you just need to fill these data and then have a demonstration, like have a, like take a demo that it's working fine. If it works fine, it's fine. And if you have any question, comment it. And also I have not found that the calculator part done by you all. So upload the calculator assignment as well. If you find any issue out there, most of you haven't uploaded the assignment yet. So if you find any issue for that, also write that in the comment section of this video. I'll be explaining that as well. So that's it. Thank you.